dessert and dinner and then more dessert. We got coffee, we got more beer, we got cake.
Yeah, we got heaps to do.
Yes, rocks. I feel wonderful.
Hey, I'm Nagesh from Manzé in North Melbourne.
And I'm Jack from Hub Street Radio in Collingwood. And a couple of nights ago, Square and Broadsheet followed us around on a food tour of the inner north of Melbourne to hit a couple of spots that are classic for us and also to see a couple of new ones.
First place we went to, Caretaker's Cottage. A good meeting point for both of us. Top of a city, Caretaker's is a tiny pub. Great music, great people, and Guinness on tap.
Give us up.
Yoo-hoo!
Matt introduced us to splitting the G.
Apparently when you take your first sip of Guinness, you're meant to like cut the G with where you end up after your first sip.
I was so close and I felt so proud until Nagesh turned his glass around and he'd blown me out of the water with like a perfect 10 out of 10 score.
And then we had the Caretaker's Welsh Rarebit. I'm actually not too sure where it comes from, but I'm guessing somewhere in the UK.
I'd say Wales.
One of the best executions of cheese on toast. And that little bottle of extra Worcestershire to really jazz it up was a nice touch. Jack and I used to eat there together a lot. This was just a really great chance to do that again.
Then we jumped in a maxi taxi and headed to Kenefe Nabalsaya up in Coburg. I was so excited to hit this spot because I grew up in the Middle East, in Saudi Arabia, and these sweets are sweets that I grew up eating. If you're looking for Arabic sweets, the northern suburbs is truly like a haven. We arrived and Musa took us right into the belly of the bees and we learned how to make kenefe.
Yeah. I showed the video to someone and they were like, this looks like the set of Wallace and Gromit. Just that crazy machine and the contraption is so magical, but it doesn't even come close to the finished product. It takes on that syrup, but it's so crispy, gooey from the cheese as well.
Yeah, it's remarkably unique. The kenefe spot was a particularly special one for me to hit. And it's so far exceeded my very high expectations.
Yeah, and then it was dinner time. Hopping off the tram down Sydney Road to Vola Foods on Oven Street. Straight to the till to meet Ash, one of the most energetic, passionate people in the game. Ash serves Cameroonian food, lots of it cooked on her charcoal grill. I had to go in that night for the burning fish. Marinated in this real herby, green chili, lemon sort of paste.
By the time the fish hit the table, I was so hungry.
Yeah.
I think because like the kenefe had like lit my appetite. Digging into that thing with our hands was such a joy, and then the food just didn't stop coming.
The food and that chili and spice, vibrant flavors. You're like a kid in Mauritius again.
We jumped in an Uber and went to Bar Liberty, which was our final spot of the night and also my final spot of many nights. My dear friend Chef Ellie knocked off work just around the corner and came and joined us for a glass of wine. The charming and handsome Dominic came and gave us a little bit of bubbly wine to start the end of our night.
Cake has been the thing that keeps drawing me back, and I think the same for you.
100% for me. I say to everyone, I'm like, Zach's cake always rivals any of the best cakes and the best bakeries in this town. We had ginger cake with mead custard.
Perfect mix of savory and sweet. Indulgent, but not over the top. Tasty, interesting, great people.
It was such a nice night. A friend of mine recently was speaking about what he looks for when he goes out, and it all, for him, boils down to whether or not it sparks joy. And I think for me and for you as well, that when we go out to eat, we're not looking to hit any sort of like specific spot. We're not looking to achieve anything much further than does it spark joy.
Yeah,
that
absolutely.
Night certainly sparked joy.
Yeah.